we view Nikola's response as a tacit admission of securities fraud. Earlier this week, Nikola issued a response to Hindenburg's original report, and I found it completely inadequate. The highlight of that is when they said they never said their truck could actually work, they just said it was in motion, and that's our bad for assuming that when we see a commercial of a truck moving down a road, that it's actually able to drive and it's not rolling down a hill. But Hindenburg has made a response, and as we go through, we can see all of Nikola's responses. There's not that many of them. They didn't address all the points. So I'm going to be going through this whole thing so you don't have to, reading it point by point and giving you my thoughts. So here we go. Last week, we issued a report that presented extensive evidence of a litany of material false statements made by Nikola's founder and executive chairman, Trevor Milton. We included 53 questions at the end of our report that we believe shareholders deserve answers to. The company promised a full point-by-point rebuttal, but then only responded to 10 of our questions. Of those 10 responses, the company debunked nothing. Instead, it either confirmed or sidestepped virtually everything we wrote about, and in some cases, raised new unanswered questions. I agree, that's exactly how I felt. Nikola admitted that its deceptive Nikola One in Motion video was in fact video of the semi-truck simply rolling down a hill. The company says it never claimed the truck was powering itself, despite extensive editing and claims that it had 1,000 horsepower with sports performance. In our report, we explained how the company released a video called Nikola One in Motion, which made it seem that Nikola One's semi-truck was traveling under its own power at a high rate of speed. Angles in the video were edited to make it appear as though the semi was moving on a roadway that was flat or even uphill. And one thing as we're going through this is you have to realize that when Nikola wrote that defense, it was the most airtight thing they could write. Lawyers peeling through every single word to make sure that they don't accidentally commit fraud again. And they are essentially admitting that, yeah, they kind of misled people, but that's not their fault. And the rest of their answers don't get much better. It's a lot of wordplay and mischaracterization of what they said or our interpretation of what they said. It's really, really sketchy what they're doing in their response, and I encourage you to watch videos breaking those down. But again, we're going to go through a lot of it today. In Monday's response, the company acknowledged that its vehicle was not functioning under its own power and instead was apparently simply showcasing the power of gravity. It claimed that using the term in motion dispelled the deceptive nature of the video. So, I mean, I called this in my previous video. The fact that they used the word in motion was to give themselves plausible deniability, and they used it right here. That's so disingenuous. We disagree. Beyond common sense, the truck... The company referred to Nikola One as the 1,000 horsepower zero emission Nikola One semi-truck in the description of its video. Obviously, the truck can't have 1,000 horsepower or even 1 horsepower if it doesn't power itself. It's the truth. You can see even this comment here. Behold the 1,000 horsepower zero emission Nikola One. On January 15th, they posted the video to its corporate page. Underneath the video are a series of comments that are answered by Nikola's verified corporate Facebook account. In response to inquiries about the video, the company confirmed the Nikola One had over 1,000 horsepower and over 2,000 feet-pounds of torque and can handle a 7% grade no problem. Readers would have likely interpreted this as an ability to climb up a 7% grade hill, not roll down a very steep hill. The company also told one person, "Wait until you drive it. Feels like a luxury car with sports performance." Given the public statements Nikola was making at the time, we view the company's new admission that the Nikola One was not powered on its own in the video as a tacit admission to securities fraud. That's what it looks like to me. I mean, tell me what you think. If a company said all of these things and showed you that video, would you assume that it's driving, or would you think like, oh no, that's just a concept, or at someday it's gonna drive, but clearly that doesn't work? Well, tell me what you think, because I don't know, maybe I'm crazy. Nikola claims that the Nikola One semi was not a pusher because it was designed to move under its own powertrain. It then admits the truck didn't ever move using its own powertrain. Okay. I'm trying to find a good analogy to that. That's like, I mean, that's like selling something on eBay saying, this TV works, and then you get it and it's broken. And then you say, well, I mean, it's designed to work. I think that's a good analogy. It's lying. This is this is just straight up lying. As we wrote in December 2016, the company falsely claimed at Nikola World on video that the Nikola One fully functions and works. This is a real truck. This is not a pusher. It later admitted that it was not fully functional to Bloomberg. The response didn't address Trevor's statements that it functions and works. Heavily lowered language clumsily attempted to redefine the term pusher, suggesting that because Nikola hoped its non-functional vehicle would work someday, that therefore it wasn't a pusher at the time. Their law firm, Kirkland & Ellis, is really doing their best with what they have to work with, but Trevor continually gets his foot stuck in his mouth, and he emphatically denied on video that the truck was a pusher. This isn't just a pusher like a lot of vehicles that they unveil are just vehicles that don't actually functioning. This is a fully functioning vehicle, which is really incredible. I mean, honestly, if Trevor just talked half as much as he did, they would probably be in half as much trouble. Everything that's coming to the foreground is just so many lies by Trevor. With that definition in mind, we offer a reminder that Nikola and Trevor reassured investors that the Nikola One Semi worked at least six times. You can pause and read these six times here. Let's move on. So on to the next point. In Hindenburg's report, former employees told us that no further work continued on Nikola One after 2016, even though the company was still publicly claiming in 2018 that the Nikola One would soon be ready. Referring to the Nikola One in motion video, a company tweet in June 2018 stated that pre-production units would hit fleets in 2019 for testing, which was false. Former employees told us that no further work continued on the Nikola One after the 2016 demonstration. Yesterday, Nikola stated that it ultimately decided not to invest additional resources into completing the process to make the Nikola One drive on its own compulsion. That's like the longest way of saying, yeah, we quit. Nikola's decision to ultimately halt investments is not the issue. The company's failure to acknowledge that it had halted investment while telling investors work continued is the problem and represents another clear case of making knowingly misleading statements. Next point, Hindenburg's report. Nikola and Trevor hyped a letter of intent to acquire battery technology company Zapco. The tech turned out to be vaporware. After Nikola realized this, they continued to hype it anyway. Nikola's response: it wasn't Zapco we were hyping. The game-changing battery tech is part of a secret R&D agreement we can't provide any details on. Also, we are using GM's battery technology. Yeah, I mean, you guys just don't get it. We have this secret stuff going on that we can't provide any details on. So you guys are wrong, but we have no proof and you'll just have to take our word for it. In our report, we pointed out that Nikola had introduced the Nikola battery prototype cell and called it game-changing battery technology in November 2019. Trevor Milton also hyped it as technology that would make diesel trucks obsolete for good, a bold statement, on November 18th, 2019. The company originally called it game-changing and the biggest advancement we have seen in the battery world. In Nikola's response from yesterday, however, the technology now is only described as potential battery technology advancements. There's a difference there, right? When you say you made something that is game-changing versus you have the potential to make something. This is different. One is it happened. One is it's not happening. It didn't happen. It's just a dream. Our report noted that the letter of intent with Zapco was signed within 2 days of a tweet teasing the press release on the battery technology. The press release then referenced the letter of intent stating, Nikola entered a letter of intent to acquire a world-class battery engineering team. Zapco was later accused by Nikola of fraud, false representations, and failure to disclose that its president had been indicted for tax fraud. It goes without saying that funding academic research is not the same thing as acquiring a team of engineers, as the original game-changing announcement indicated. I think that speaks for itself, so you'll see a pattern of Trevor Milton is saying something and then it's just not true. He'll say that they have the technology or they develop something when they, in fact, they're not even developing it, they're in the process of acquiring a team that could develop it. And then he'll just say that it's happening, it's here, or, you know, it's under works. And it's just so deceptive. Trevor claimed to have reduced the cost of hydrogen by 81% relative to peers and was producing 1,000 kilograms of hydrogen per day at Nikola's headquarters. Nikola's response confirmed that none of this happened. Nikola continues to believe that its planned hydrogen station network will provide key competitive advantages. What are you saying? That's like saying, I have made an invisible plane. And then the reality is, I believe that I have the capability of providing an invisible plane. One is it exists, one it does not. You could not lie harder than these two statements. It's not even wordplay anymore. These are just straight up lies. What are you talking about? At Nikola World 2019, Trevor claimed on video, in America, we've already got the largest hydrogen station in the Western Hemisphere at our headquarters, can produce over 1,000 kilograms a day on site. He reiterated several times in public interviews. In August 2020, we saw an opportunity to bring the cost of hydrogen down, going zero emission and putting it on parity with diesel. And it's the first time in history that that's been able to be done. So it went from $16 per kilograms, and we are now down to $4 per kilograms. So not only do they have this amazing hydrogen technology, they've actually cut the cost by over 75%. Amazing. Amazing. More proof here. We have a tweet. We have 8 stations going up right now. This is 2 years ago. As acknowledged by the company statement Monday, it has no hydrogen network and simply hopes to have one in the future. This once again strikes us as a tacit admission of securities fraud. I can't even speak anymore. My mouth is like, what am I reading? Hindenburg's report. Trevor Milton falsely claimed in 2020 that 5 Nikola trade trucks were coming off the assembly line right now. Keyword is right now. Bloomberg corroborates the assembly line isn't finished. Okay, so you know what? If I say I'm coming over right now, I guess I could be late for a little bit, like an hour, a couple minutes. Maybe I could be late for half a day. Okay, fine. Maybe I'm late for a whole day and I could still use the term right now. But if the assembly line isn't even finished, bro, I'm coming over to your house right now. Let's say a year later. Why didn't you come over? Oh, I don't have legs. Yeah, I don't even have the thing to get the coming over started. So if you don't have an assembly line, how are the trucks supposed to be coming off the line? It's not even that they were in progress. You didn't have the materials to build the trucks. That's next level. I don't know how he stretches his brain to come up with this stuff. Bloomberg has since confirmed our work, writing those statements were a mischaracterization of Nikola's and Iveco's process in Ulm, according to 2 people familiar with the matter. The assembly line is still under construction and is not yet operational or building prototypes, the people said. There are prototypes being built by hand in a workshop, one of the people said. On Friday, Trevor tweeted pictures of unfinished Nikola trade trucks in a work area that is clearly not an assembly line. Nice. Yeah, this looks like it's at like the Air and Space Museum or something. This definitely does not look like an assembly line. Moving on, Hindenburg says, Nikola's order book is fluff, including a $3.5 billion order from a company with only $1.3 million in cash. Nikola's response, we have an order from a different company that we hope to begin delivery on in 3 years. That feels like sidestepping. In our report, we pointed out that the company's order book appeared to be filled with fluff, including non-committal orders and orders where potential customers like Anheuser-Busch have multiple outs. We showed that U.S. Express reportedly accounts for a third of its reservations, representing $3.5 billion in orders, yet U.S. Express had only $1.3 million in cash on hand last quarter. And Nikola doesn't really have a good response for that. Hindenburg says, the company's unveiling of its NZT off-road vehicle deceptively presented a mock-up as if it was market-ready. Following the unveiling, the project was then outsourced for redesign. Nikola responded by rewording our statements and then declaring the reworded statements to be false. Nikola is claiming that Hindenburg said that the program was scrapped, but actually it wasn't because the design was outsourced to a third party called Stellar Strategy. But if you read their report, Hindenburg does say that Nikola outsourced the redesign to another small company. Do you see that? They just changed what Hindenburg said to say that, oh, you guys said our program is canceled. Oh, but it's not. We outsourced it. Hindenburg said that. Nikola is just deliberately misconstruing what Hindenburg had said to make them look bad. And it just doesn't really make sense. Hindenburg says, why would Trevor appoint his brother as a director of hydrogen production infrastructure, given he had no apparent experience in hydrogen technology? This is one of the more ridiculous ones. And Nikola's response is Travis Milton ran a construction business. Now, I don't want to totally like put this down. I think if you were a big CEO of a super large construction business, there might be some skills that you could really bring to this. But director of hydrogen production seems like a pretty technical role that requires a lot of specific knowledge, right? And the thing is, Trevor Milton's brother didn't even run a large construction business. He just made a lot of driveways with concrete, and they're good. It looked like good work. I wouldn't, you know, make him in charge of hydrogen, just like I wouldn't have him be my lead software engineer, or just doesn't seem like the best person for the job. And this is gold. When faced with this question again in a since deleted Instagram rant, Trevor said, "Why do you give a shit? Go start your own company. Hire your own employees." That is some A+ quality CEOing. In Hindenburg's report, Trevor claimed on video that Nikola's inverters were developed in-house and that OEMs were asking to use them. In that same video, he is showcasing an inverter manufactured by Cascadia with masking tape covering its label. Nikola's response admits this is true, then deflects by vaguely stating that the company has been working on its own inverters for some time. Yeah, do you see the pattern? They say that we developed this in-house, this is ours, we made it, and the reality is, oh, we're working on it. Totally different. Recently, the company's CEO, current CEO, Mark Russell, who is a lot more level-headed and careful with his words, walked back the company's claims to have vast proprietary technology when pressed by reporters from the Financial Times on Friday. Asked about Mr. Milton's claims to have all the core technology for its vehicles, Mr. Russell described the company as an integrator, stitching together the many elements of its vehicles from a complex supply chain. So there is a big difference between being an integrator that takes a lot of things and integrates them and being the company that creates proprietary technology. That's different, right? Could you please let me know in the comments below if that's different, because maybe I am insane. Here we can see the picture with Trevor Milton's finger while he narrates a behind the scenes video pointing at the Cascadia inverter with masking tape right here over its label. About 15 minutes before proclaiming, Nikola makes all its own inverters. So if he says that, if he points to an inverter and say, "We make all of our own inverter," are we not supposed to think that you made this inverter? Or is that our fault again, that we assume that because you're pointing at something and you say, "We make that," that, oh, no, that doesn't mean that we made the one that I'm pointing at. I'm just saying we are designing stuff that looks like this, maybe potentially in the future. What the hell is going on? In Hindenburg's report, they presented evidence that Trevor misled potential investors in a predecessor entity by inflating a $16 million deal with trucking company Swift into a $300 million deal. Nikola claims the deal could have been $250 million with options. Swift didn't exercise those options and instead sued D-Hybrid over misrepresentations with its original $16 million deal. So not only did Trevor lie about the worth of this deal, he kind of added in all this other money that could have been on the table, which, again, the pattern. Even the original $16 deal wasn't even worth it. They were sued over it. So this is, yeah, ridiculous. Nikola also failed to address 43 out of 53 of Hindenburg's questions. Now, not all of these are fair, like number 11, do you think it's wise to threaten to sue journalists for getting a story totally incorrect? But it's funny. I like Hindenburg's clapbacks. They're throwing it down, man. This is really fun to read. In conclusion, Nikola's response had holes big enough to roll a truck through. We remain short shares of Nikola Corp. And there's a legal disclaimer. You have to remember that Hindenburg is short in this company, so they have a vested interest in seeing it go down. At the same time, given what they have shown us and all the proof and the receipts, let me know what you think. Am I crazy? I think they have committed fraud, or at the most generous interpretation is that Milton is a pathological liar and he shouldn't be a part of the company, or they need a complete management revamp. Maybe Nikola has done a lot of great things that we don't know about, but everything that they've proclaimed to have made, there are just so many holes and so many lies. I don't know. You guys tell me. But that's it. I hope that was helpful or fun. If you are in Nikola, I'm sorry. There are definitely people that have been calling out Nikola for a while, but to the extent that now it's been organized into a very digestible thing that regular people can understand, I don't know. I don't see how you could feel safe investing in it. And now the Department of Justice has joined the SEC in investigating Nikola for the allegations that it has misled investors. Please do your own due diligence, though. I never want to tell you what to do. I can just present you the information and my personal opinion. Personally, I'm not 100% sure there's a fire, but I'm seeing a lot of smoke, and I wouldn't stay in the building if you catch my drift. That's all I have for today. This is Green Knight Trading, where squires become knights. Please like and subscribe if that was helpful or if you enjoyed that. Thank you, and I'll see you next time. Tell me everything.